Welcome back to the Shtick, and we've still got with us Ephraim Finch from the Hevra Kedisha. And we were talking about memory, weren't we, and how to keep the memory of your loved ones.
Yes, and you mentioned to me about Elie Wiesel.
Mm-hmm.
I have a book about called Memories, where a Jew has to remember. Memories past. I should be able to quote what he wrote. When a child left the family, he was told, "Remember, you are a Jew."
Mm-hmm.
Because the memory is what keeps us going.
It is. It's a link. The link we always have.
In all generations, not just Jewish, Australian.
Mm.
It's so important. What I try to do at the Hevra is when a family comes in to bury their loved one, or even to buy a plot, a burial plot, I sit down with them and get their history. I start asking their names, their Hebrew names. What they were called in Poland, not what they're called out here now.
Mm-hmm.
Then I ask their parents' details, the parents' father, parents' mother's details. So I'm going down three generations where I can. Their siblings. Then on the other side, after the marriages, and that's where it becomes interesting about marriages, because sometimes parents won't talk about it in front of their children, but they'll talk it to me because I'm not family, I'm not a rabbi, but I'm a friend.
Mm-hmm.
And they'll give me all the insight. But what I want them to give me is where their child was born, their child's Hebrew name, not what the name they were given by a school. And then down the bottom of my form, Holocaust. And I'm trying to track down who perished. Did they have children who died? Was it a boy? Was it a girl?
Mm.
Because after the last survivor fades away, you're going to have the Holocaust deniers coming and saying it didn't happen. And as an Aussie who become into this tribe, it did happen. It did happen.
Oh, yeah, we know. I'm a son of sole survivors. Both my parents were sole survivors. Their entire tribe, their entire family was killed. And Dad was married before the war as well. He had a son, Labe. He told me his wife's name and his son's name. So I've got a connection to that, but any more I don't know, because I lost all my uncles and grandparents. So I'm a classic example of that.
Yes.
And you must get that all the time.
Well, there's a book written by Henry Lou.
Oh, yes, Henry Lou, the ophthalmologist.
About Henry Reisner, who's buried in Carlton Cemetery. Mm-hmm. He wrote some notes in Polish, Yiddish, and it was translated. And he handles the front part of the book saying, can you imagine these people coming out to Australia? They'd lost their first wife, children. The wife had lost her husband and children. Mm. Then they had to come together, getting on a boat, coming to Australia, not speaking the language, working. Did they have any people looking after them for their mental stability? See, that's why people should marry my family, because we don't have the shtick from the Jews.
That's right. We don't have all that past. And talking about the past, there was a documentary made about you, a short film actually by Marcus Rose.
Which won the Celluloid Soup. It was presented by Libby Gore.
Uh-huh, in 2004.
Yes, and I loved how Marcus did it. He was such a sly person.
And we've got Marcus coming up in the next segment talking about his shtick, which is art. He's a great artist and an entrepreneur. And we will go out now at the end of the segment with a little clip, the end of the... We can't show the whole 8 minutes, but we will show the last couple of minutes of the bit where you are actually in action. So we'll see you in situ at the Hevra Kedisha.
A lot younger.
Not that much. It was only a few years ago. And look, it's been a real pleasure. You are a treasure, by the way, Ephraim. The whole community thinks of you so highly. I personally think of you in the highest esteem, because you do it. Mm. Thank you.
We
always kiss. And that's part of our shtick, and because he's such a warm, caring human being. You're a mensch, Ephraim.
And thank you for having me. It's a pleasure to be here.
Thank you.
Anybody and wants to call me, please call me.
Yep, he's online anytime. You can just Google, have the address there. And, yeah, life is for the living.
Life's too serious, but so enjoy it.
So enjoy it. That's what we say. We'll see you after the break with Marcus Rose.
Here is where the water is connected to the rainwater. Let me put the cook from the carrier of the fish over here. Chesed ve'emet atah tzvitanu lehit aset. It's all talking about loving kindness. And when you say all this part, and when we come down here, tahara, 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 you say that part when you're immersing the body into the mikvah. No matter how the body goes into the water, when it comes out of the water, it always looks different. We have a leg which has to go out, and a toe. So it's a left hand. I must be careful what size they are, because unfortunately a lady lost both legs once, the left and right leg, and I never put on the coffin left and right, so when I put them in her coffin, I don't know whether I put the left on the left-hand side and the right on the right-hand side. So when the resurrection of the dead takes place, she may get up with the legs on the wrong side. That's a bit of back humour, I'm sorry. We will prepare a body. Everybody in here has to prepare a body, because that's the way we run. We run close to the wind. We bury anybody, like the shortest time we've buried anybody from a bed to the grave is 2.5 hours, and that takes a little bit of effort to organise that. But don't forget the holiness of the life. It may be dead, the body, but it contained the spirit. Like with my granddaughter dying, why did it happen? But I still have faith to believe that God directs the world. I don't know what neshama that little girl was carrying, why it came only for that amount of time. And I've got to have belief that God runs the world every moment, because if his presence wasn't in this world, our world would crumble.